The narrator is an interesting man, and by that I mean he's a terrible man. Okay, terrible is a bit of a stretch, maybe. He was one of the many people involved in the Call Me Carson drama, backstabbing Carson while crying for sympathy points. A perfect example of this is when he mentioned Carson making fun of his health or something. Here's the problem with situations and people like this. When you take this approach, it can easily be demolished and devalued if you don't clear your skeletons. Ooh, but what does that mean, Sen? Well, when you take the narrator's approach, you're relying on the image that you're a better person than the person that you're talking about. So when people realize that you're not, and in fact you're a hypocrite, and worse yet, a weak individual that needs to rely on emotion to further push their agenda, and points, you take a major hit. More so than, say, someone like me that tells you from the get-go that I'm a mean person, but I do have a limit on certain things. I embrace my faults, don't get me wrong. I don't gather in mobs to get things done. I take on mobs by myself. This has been proven many times by the way I take on the commentary mafia. Not trying to stroke myself off or anything, but that's just the fucking fact. Come on now. And thus, that gains me admiration and even, dare I say, a bit of respect. Of course, this puts a lot of mental strain for a variety of reasons, and I wouldn't recommend just anyone to go through this unless they're prepared. And I definitely would not recommend the narrator do this or any of the people that ganged up on Carson, because it's pretty self-evident that they're weak, quote-unquote, men that gather in groups to push messages and agendas. And trust me, I'm using the term men very loosely here. They have no problem going after someone with the charisma of wet paint. That would be Carson, by the way. No offense, buddy. Oh, but I'm a biased Carson fanboy. No, I'm actually not. I just don't like people like you, you see. It's not that hard to put together, right? If I don't like people like you, and I want to go ahead and maybe just poke holes in your story because you get on my bad side, and because you annoy me, and because you do these really malicious things, that doesn't make me a stan, that doesn't make me a fanboy, that's just me being me, bro. Okay, so let's get this fanboy and stan thing out of the way, because that's your go-to thing for any person, and I think it's quite silly. But anyway, it's time to get to the juicy stuff, and I'll make it as short and to the point as I can. Yesterday, a thread was brought to my attention highlighting certain things that contradict the narrator's established moral compass. The way the narrator portrayed his moral compass, or at least the impression that people got from his one-hour wine fest, is that he was a victim, as well as being manipulated by Big Bad Carson. And Carson was not mindful of age gaps, etc., etc. However, certain Discord DMs highlight that the narrator had no problem having a server with minors posting some not very safe things, and only recently did he decide to clean the place up. This completely contradicts what we've been told to believe, that Carson is a bad apple we should take offense with, and the narrator isn't the some scorned quote-unquote friend of his doing this for the sole purpose of getting back at Carson for whatever petty reason that might be. I actually have a theory that Carson might have realized how messed up the narrator was early, and maybe that's why their friendship started having some turmoil or something. Like I said, I didn't watch the narrator's wine fest because I'm not a fedora tipper that believes quote-unquote victims, all victims, especially when these quote-unquote victims have shown nothing but malice as of late, as well as throwing false pedophile accusations, allegations, or getting stories wrong on Drama Alert. No, hug box. And Sam, I'm looking at you, you two big girls. At the end of the day, not only is the narrator a hypocrite that may very well be self-projecting onto Carson, but he is also bordering the line of an SJW that can't even live up to the mantra. I tagged him on Twitter as a way to reach out for comment on one of the screenshots from his server, and he did not deny it or even address it despite his feed not being very active compared to many other YouTubers. I guess it really is in his best interest to ignore this shot to his character, because if he addresses it, there will be more pushback. Now that little cracks have been shown in the story, they're going to have to pull some good stuff in the next coming weeks, months, however long they want to keep this going for, to legitimately accomplish what they set out to do. Whatever that is, all I can say is it definitely wasn't good, or at least it didn't look good. God, Carson, buddy, with friends like these, seriously, who needs enemies?